Howdy doody, folks. How is everyone? So I'm a bit late, I had to make some tea. Please let me know who's here. Ken Shin's band is running very warmly today for some reason. Not sure how that is. How is everybody? Good, I hope. I actually took a couple of days off at the start of this week, went to see some folks. First time in a long time, which is kind of cool. What has everyone been up to? Trying to get too hot. So what I'm going to do today is probably jump straight in on the pile stuff to make quite a bit of progress, and then I'm going to work on the kind of educational S tile or super tile. Let's just review where we are. Let me save where I am with this. So what have I done? Obviously there is the main board. Okay, so I'll get this stuff open. That's equal to one. I was a bit of a muscle in my neck as well. I'm going to suspect a little awkwardly. Let's just switch over. So this is the tile board. Let me tile carrier. This will work with black Ultimax, only up and coming black edge EP5 boards. So that's all rooted and ready to rock and roll. I don't know if I showed this last time or not. Okay, let's see. PCB, all rooted. I still haven't got a decent name for it. If anyone's got any ideas, let me know. I don't really want to call it black tiles. That's all really. And then I've been working on the tiles, so what should we do first? So look, we have the breadboard tile. This is going to be interesting. This is such a tight fit. I'm not sure. I might have to make some adjustments here. So one of those mini breadboards in the middle. That is one of these. Maybe some of these. It's got that in the middle, and then on the top and on the bottom, it's got the two female connectors. This sort of thing, like Arduino type. And that will go on the top so that you can wire the connection to the tile into the breadboard. Oh, Laurie's having a problem with his internet. Damn. Well, just have to bear with us, Laurie. I think I'm good this end so far. Fingers crossed it stays up long enough for you to see some stuff. Otherwise, we'll have to look at the YouTube version later. So that's the breadboard tile. And then the stepper tile I'm still working on. That's not. Oh, I don't even want that one. The wrong one. That's the old one. You're not using that one. Got a triple axis one. That's the new stepper one, but it's not finished yet. I'm having trouble squeezing in everything in, and I'm wondering what to do on the connectors here. I've changed the connectors on all of these. I'm trying to use the surface mount ones, which I've ordered from Alan, actually. Some samples from Alan. Let's see what they're like. If they work out for the dual axis controller, I use them on stepper as well. Although the end stops still need to go on there, and I'm trying to work out how to place those. Let me show you. Yeah, all I showed at the beginning was what you've already seen, i.e. the carrier board, rooted carrier board, which I've already shown you, Laurie. I then showed that we've got a breadboard tile that I've been working on. And then I was talking about motor tiles. The stepper tile is still under construction. The the motor why is it said that? Oh, I'm opening the wrong one. Yeah, we can help. Yeah, this is the latest dual motor one. So this is the brush motor driver. For those that have been watching along, I've changed the chip in the center of the package for a QFN version. I've also moved the extra connectors for the MU signals The end use mixed signals and the end use SPI onto the top of the board. And then all the components on the bottom. So the components will be facing down and there should be enough headroom for that to fit on. It's going to be interesting to see how that works. The other thing I've changed here is the connectors. So these are surface mount connectors. It's going to be interesting to see how well those work. And I'll show those when I get them. Explain how those, basically they clasp the cables. I'm hoping those are going to work. So it makes it an entirely surface mount construction, most of which is on one side with some optional components on the other side. That's quite important to get stuff done. So that one's rooted and ready to rock and roll. I'm just checking a few things on it. That supports a dual brushed motor, so two brushed motors and two quadrature encoders, one for each. If you've ever seen the sort of motors that we're looking at supporting here, this is something that I've used before in the past, and also stuff. These sort of motors on the bottom here, can you see them? So these have a built-in encoder at the end here. So the wire that comes out from there, you've got an A and B from the Hall effect sensor, plus you've got the plus and minus of the motor, plus you've got power, the Hall effect, low voltage power as well. So for each motor, you've effectively got six wires to connect. That's why we've got 12 of these connector blocks on the schematic here. So that's kind of ready to go. I'm just double checking. It's all passing the VRC at the moment. I'm just looking at optimizing and stuff. All of that. The other thing that I worked on was the I mentioned the breadboard one. Laurie's saying one of my latest MIGIN projects was an encoder motor controller. Yeah, I mean, the encoder in this case is a bit limited because it's directly attached to the to the motor output. It corresponds to the wheel turning, which is good because it's the other side of the gears, but it won't tell you if you have slippage, for example. So, you know, you'd have to probably differentiate wheel turning and motion, perhaps from an inertia sensor or gyro. To determine whether you're slipping on the wheels or not. They're not the perfect encoders built into the motor shaft, but it's convenient. Sorry, Tony, I haven't really tested that yet. So the other ones that I've been working on are the breadboard tile. I'll just show this again because Laurie may have missed it. That's the breadboard tile. To repeat myself, and that has one of these in the middle, Laurie, and then it has female connectors at the top and bottom, which have the signal to the tile. But it's really tight. I don't know if that's going to work. It is really, really tight. That fits. The other thing was what. Something that Laurie in particular wanted is the PMOD fire, which is done as well, that's rooted. So that enables you to fit on a single PMOD. If I say a single PMOD, it's actually like a double PMOD. Two lines. like one of these. The two rows. I've also added these connectors for the unused signal so that those can come out if you want to use them. So the SPI and I2C, which obviously don't go down with PMODs, and then the mixed signals as well that aren't being used on the PMODs. So those are all broken out as well, which is kind of cool. So that's done, ready and rooted. That's what I have. I'm still working on the network tile. And that's going to change a little bit. I need to reconfigure that slightly. I won't be adding the Wi-Fi on that because that's actually going to go onto the super tile. I've still got the camera one to do. Why can't I see it? Where is it? This one have I done also this week. So this is the prototype. This is quite interesting. Slightly different from the previous prototype. We also had an extender or test PMOD in our armory last time. Now you can't easily do that on a tile because of the mechanical features of a tile. You can't easily do a board in the middle. But what I'm doing here is the connector for the tile connection is on the bottom here. But on the top, you can actually put this 2.54 surface mount header. And that exposes all the main signals with ground on the other side. So you can connect that directly into the logic analyzer, just using an IDC code, which is kind of cool. And then you can have your PMOD pieces here. So all those signals are exposed on the first row here. And then the extra signals like SPI on the top and STA on the bottom. And then you've got uncommitted holes for prototyping here. And then at the end, you can fit in a connector at the right angle, 2.54 pitch, or vertical 2.54 pitch, which is connected to this last row here. And then across the top, you've got power, plus 3 volts, ground, and then the same at the bottom, plus 3 volts and ground. So it's kind of half proto, half breadboardy type arrangement, but with a test header that can be soldered on, so you can use it as a dual purpose board. So you get double the benefit. So I'm interested to know what you think on that, Mike. I always use the extender boards for breaking out the signals when I'm doing my PMOD work. It's very useful. So having this format here, which I can plug directly into the logic analyzer, is great. And I can do that whether I'm doing the prototype or not, because I can just route the signal to that tile. But it's also useful if you're trying to create a new prototype or a patch your different times of type of connection where you can monitor the signals as well. So you've kind of got that man in the middle ability, which is nice. So I quite like that. If anyone wants any other features on these, do let me know before I, you know, I'm going to get some. The whole point of doing this is try and get all of these ordered for early doors next week so that I can test the whole thing out. Yeah, it's all working. I think that's all of the tiles. I mean, I've got others I'm working on, but they're not finished. Done the breadboard. Done the motor and motor encoders. The triple axis stepper one. Not quite finished yet, there's still more to go on there. The network tile I'm still working on. Remote tile I've shown you, poker tile I've shown you, the motor encoder I've shown you as well. So what I was going to work on today was the super tile. So let me remind you where we are here. The super tile is the one that fits here, at the top in the middle. And that has more I.O. than the others. It's not like the standard tiles around the edge. So I was going to work on one of those. I've got several designs. One is with the camera and Wi-Fi. And then the other is an educational one, and that's what I'm going to work on today. So I've already made a start on this. This one. So this one is for FPGA intros and learning. I call it the FPGA 101 for the moment. So what this has on it, let me show you schematic first. If you look at the schematic, what we have here is obviously we've got the super tile connector on the left hand side here. We're only using a fraction of the connection. But all of these are available on Black Ice, on Ice Core as well. So it's compatible with that as well as the newer boards. We've got a 7-segment display here. These are the common anodes, the control transistors for the common anodes that enable each digit. And then each digit has, including the decimal point, so there's 8 inputs through a resistor network array. And those are driven by P0 through to P7. The cathodes are 13, 14, and 15, which drive the anodes are driven by P13, 14, 15 here. Alternately, if the switch is flipped, what that does is that enables the signals to go through the buffer, and output enables here through this resistor network in order to create a VGA signal. And then additionally, we have the horizontal and vertical sinks as well. And then we've got an audio connector for the HP2. 89 signals here as well. So this board will do either 7-segment plus audio, or it will do VGA plus audio. And that's quite good. So you can do things like all the examples in the FPGA book, Simon Monk's book, for example. You can use, presumably, your code covers this as well, doesn't it, Laurie? Your samples. I can't remember. Too many boxes. So here was when I was working on a potential FPGA, a carrier for Black Ice before, what I wanted to do was an educational one. This never actually made it out, by the way. I mean, some of you may have seen this. That had the 7 segment on it. Had the VGA. Also had some audio there. So I'm really just reusing that design, and I'm putting that onto our super tile in the middle. And I've already got the components for these as well, so I don't have to worry about sourcing them, which is kind of cool. Got lots of them. I know those are popular because even when I did a PMOD just with a 7-seg on it, those were really popular. Although it was badly designed in many ways. It took me ages to build each one. There were so many through-hole components on it. So this is designed to be a bit simpler than that. Even so, there's still quite a bit of soldering I have to do. There are 15 pins on the VGA connector. There are 12 pins on the 7 segment. There are 4-5 pins on the audio connector and another 3 pins on the switch that enables you to switch between the two modes, either 7 segment or VGA. So odd pins. So it's less, significantly less than all the through-hole components, but still significant. So let's work on this today. Any questions before I move on the tile front? Is everybody kind of up to speed on what I'm working on here? Cool. Tell you what is weird is if I pick this up and rotate this, What happened? It's weird. Not really rotating. I've done something and I can't think what it is. What have I set that for? It means that it's always the right way up. Yeah, we got that in effect. So, let me just move these around a bit here. Please do let me know what you guys have been up to. Let me know. As I'm doing this. I'm going to just go away for now. What have you all been up to this week? As I said, I was lucky because I managed to get away and see some folks for the first time since lockdown. It was kind of nice. And also took a couple of days off to do some reading, socialising with folks. Which was nice. It was almost like normal. That's probably not going to last. If I don't sound too negative. Given this Delta variant, I don't think you're going to get away with it that easy. Anyone else had a chance to get away a little bit at all yet? Catch up with family again? Let's check in the number. Hey, how much room? I'm going to move it this way a little bit. Going to visit your sister in Sandhurst. That's just up the road from me, Laurie. But the trains weren't available. Oh. I think they have restricted seating at the moment. And it was a bank holiday. Oh, well, everyone travelling. Yeah, I'm just literally a few miles down the road from Sandhurst. About 5 miles from here, if that. 5 or 10. This is going to be a bit tricky. And change the dial. Looks like with my bias. Well, let me know if you want to meet up, Laurie, when you might not have enough time. You're probably too busy. If you do fancy meeting up, just let me know. Consistent with these. I guess that there already. He's tight as hell, man. I think these are going to be rather tight. Okay, that's some adjustments there. Oops. Yeah, I'm just going to get it rooted first off. So I'll make a fine tuning at the end. There's going to be some bit of an overlap. Yeah, this one's going to be particularly tricky. That's easy. The last one looks tricky. This one's an issue. We're going to have to go right out and back in again. And here. I'm going to come through on the wrong side. Oh, this is it. We have to go all the way around the houses. No, it's not going to work. I'm going to get this one out. I don't have to do some stuff in here. I think that might be too tight. I'm going to have to narrow this sucker down. It's just too fat to fit through. Very rough to start with. I'll complain about that of this anyway. I'm going to make sure I can root something without moving it around too much. Okay. Lightly hard, let's put that down a step. There's a 32-32. Let's take that down to 31.7. 31.7. No, that's too much. I'm talking about. One point nine. This may be too much. 1.9. 1.5. I don't know if that's gonna do it or not. Yeah, now I'm hitting the other side. Okay. I'm gonna have to go. There you are. I have to do this. Yes. Squeezed it in there, and now I'm not pressing the air compressor. Okay, right, then we have this left. Lovely. So I'm looking forward to being able to test some of these as well. And troubleshoot some of the mechanicals. Hit with them lining up. I'm probably going to have to sand some of them down slightly. Yeah, this is going to be pushed and shoved around those missions there. Anyway, let's continue with this. Let's see if we can move some of this in there. How's that one going? Oh, it's going really well. Now my sound noise is quite grand, I'm going to have to look at this. This is taking like a lot more noise. One of those. Eight days of life or something like that. Hold on. I got the jam around there. Oops, and there's one on the inside, aren't there? Should I move? It's right, because of the noise. Working out where we're going with these. These are the anode controls. I've left myself a little room. What else we gotta get over? There's three. What do these three here? It's a bit messy. And then this one is going to come out. Open all the variables. What's this over here? Interesting. Come on. Ah, wow, that's inconvenient. It's going all the way down and back up. Let's rearrange a few of these. I'm using P2 warrior ones, but they're having to use the resistors in this arrangement here because I'm reusing the spare resistors here. Ah, de doo de doo de da, that makes it more difficult. That's rather annoying. The only other possibility is change which pins we're using on here. Change. Yeah, the P9 definitely pulled up. Right. On that audio connector, I've got two connections. So I can do two out, one in, one out. Or two in. What's the best combination, Laurie, on the audio side, do you think? Or anyone else for that matter, actually? I may not use this. I may just use DC blocking instead. Laurie, I'm just. I've got two. The audio connection. The connector has two either inputs or outputs. What's the best? Is it best just to do two outputs? Is there any advantage of having one input, one output, or just going straight for two outputs? I'm just doing two outputs right now, that's all. Unless you think. No, it's one jack. It's like an audio stereo jack on here. Can't see it, hold on. This one. So I can have stereo out, or I can have audio out and audio in. One of each mono. Okay, so just a reminder, refresh. So this is the kind of educational or learning tile, the 101 tile. VGA, obviously. Audio, which is what I'm talking about now in the 7-segment. And the 7-segment VGA are switchable. There's a switch to switch between the two. So you can only drive one at once. So at the moment, what I'm doing is I'm doing two audio outputs, unless somebody asks me to do anything different. The VGA is 8-bit color, so it's red and green have 3 bits and blue has 2 bits. It's a super tile. We don't have digital tile anymore, we have super tile. The super tile has a few more connections on it. But yeah, the exceptional tile, if you like. Right. So whilst you haven't think about that, I'm just going to finish off this pane. Like this needs to. Damn, can be tricky. I'm gonna need to shut this along a little bit. It's going to require a little untangling in a minute. This is awkward. That's what we're doing. Okay. Let's move this. And then this is about here. Right, I need to clean something out from this. Cool, right. That what I do, let me just undo that because I've just suddenly thought it might be a really good idea is to do something like this and then move these. What I'm going to do is I'm going to insert this to reduce the impedance a little. Just in case it's short, so I'm going to. I'm just going to swap these around, okay? Now, what you find is something like this. Yeah. Ah, that's what we've done. Right, let's see if it's slightly up there. I don't think it's going to work. Not right. Let's just hold it there. Oh, I need to be the other way around. Right. You can pass it through myself. I just used the remaining two resistors on the reduce the impedance of it, put some resistance in series with the output, just in case of shorts. I was using the other resistors before at the other end, and I'm using these resistors, so they're probably a bit yellow. I'm going to put it down again. And back up. Right here. And same for the left. So that's what we see here. Right, let me just catch up with the comments. The only use I've ever seen for audio input connector is a cassette type input for retro. And that is so slow, I've never used it. If we have a connector for that, then it would be better as a separate one. So using your audio connector for stereo now. Much better. Yeah. Cool. This is what I've done. I'm just giving me RSI's because I already have an ache in my shoulder. From having slept on it funny. Chewing can didn't help them. I've got to do a switch. It's a switch. That's kind of available. Mm-hmm. Not right. I do visit my friend next. And what I've got left here are my two video signals. Well, it's all the videos I've got to link now. Do this now. Oh yes, I remember that. This is the new slide. Yeah, go over that. And then this. Okay. Okay. Yes. Okay. Let's sort that out. And the ground plane. Small pieces here for the handle, not as high. That's the one. Okay. Right, check out the brain, now I'm playing in a moment. Got some other issues here. I've got some connections that aren't complete. Where's my other air wires? Oh, what's this here? Is that ground? Right, yeah, ones have I got? Two. Right, where are they? I've just got the two sometimes. Oh, what do you need now? Can I see the damn things? Can I have everything off? Oh, there's one. Oh, there's one here. Right. That's the wires connected up here. This one and this one. Who did I miss that? That is damn awkward. Not good. What was I thinking? Should be on the inside, the other one should be on the outside. Really. Okay. The adjustment required. Annoying. Right. Better way of doing this. Not used to do. That one there. Underground. That's it. No airlocks. These are rooted. And it needs some optimization. It's kind of it, roughly. Let's separate some of these out with the signal quality. Those are the refinements. What is doing my head in there is this. I can't ever take that now. That one. Yeah, I think it's a bunch of that. No. I've got this problem. What did I set this to that makes it like that? Bloody moly. Oh, how very frustrating. They do not get it. Yeah, it should go down there. That should go down there. That was wrong. If you rotate that, it was driven right now. Got me totally confused. Maybe we'll change the proportion of that one. That is good enough. I think I've had this issue before. Oh, very annoying. Sorry, it's been a bit of a quiet thing, but how are we doing for time? Yeah, I'm probably going to quit in about 10 minutes. Sometimes I'm not knackered. A lot of this I can optimize later. This is really confusing. I don't understand why it won't go the right way up. It does. How very odd, I say, how very odd. Well, it just rotates around properly, but it's not doing that. It's that bit I don't understand. Why it flips from one side to the other. Bonkers. See, when I do that, that's brilliant. I say, that is remarkably annoying. Thank you. Um, Yeah, so on this outline, hopefully if it works, we'll cut this out here. So the outline goes, comes back in here, and then goes back out. That line will be ignored. That's the plan. I have to fiddle to make that work, of course. But I have to do that in order to fit these two in, given where the holes are. Because I need to screw it down. Oh, simple, you can invest in. But it's basically rooted. I do need to optimize some of the signaling paths and stuff. Particularly for the horizontal sink. You need to double check that path maybe a little bit. That needs some optimization.
Meow.
Hello. Let's say hello to the folks. Say hello to everyone. What a good cat this week, isn't it? How many more tiles have I got to do? I think I've covered my important bases here. I wanted to do this one. What I wanted to order next week was this one, the proto tile, the. You did do a meow, maybe she was saying hello back, anticipating that. This super tile, the proto tile, the PMOD tile, and the dual motor encoder tile. Steph is going to have to wait. I've got to fiddle about with that. I don't think I'm going to have that done in time. The camera and Wi-Fi one will have to wait a bit. So I've got a lot to do on those now. The carrier, obviously. But that will be enough for us to get started and get examples working with that in the repository, getting them MyGen board file, that kind of thing. Maybe we can need some adjustment here a bit. I'm checking my design rules now, picking up on the errors. This is going to be a bit of fun. I'm taking that. It's going to be tricky, actually. Oh. Fiddly, fiddly, fiddly. Look at a bit more. A bit more over here, really. I'm going to get that. Okay. Really, yeah. This is the problem. This is still very close here. Might have to shrink this down a tad. But they do all do against me. To be fair, they don't need to be that wide. They're all very small signals. Yes, we've got stuff over here. Using that a little bit. That's it. That's all my DRC issues. Just optimization now. Okay, good. Yeah, so the second lot of boards I do will probably be like the following week or something. The step is a bit tricky. Let me show you where I am with the stepper and you'll see what I mean. No, not that one. It's the old one. We upgraded triple axis. The fitting everything on is a bit tight, but one of the issues I've got here is, let me get these out. So the way this was done before, I mean, it still needs some adjustment anyhow, it doesn't quite fit. I still need to shuffle things about, but in particular, you've got through hole components here. Now, if these surface mount components work, I'd rather use those. So those can fit in here, which means I need to reconfigure things. But I can get six of those in, which is enough for all the motor controllers, but these end stop ones won't fit in once those are in, because these are wider. But I'm thinking of putting the end stop ones on the top of the board, on the other side of the board, because this is facing down on this stuff, along with the factor. But I could actually have these two, these end stop on the top, again, using the surface mount. Quite a bit of configuration. I mean, if I have time over the weekend, I might do it. But it's just all a bit fitting on this one. It will fit in. We'll get there. This is a bit tricky. And then I'll probably have enough, I reckon, Maureen, to do the order and get some stuff ordered and tested. Ordered, well, ordered and sent, then I can build them and test them. We can do more later. And the one with Wi-Fi is a bit more complicated. That's super board, which is why I'm putting it off to a bit later because I haven't really done my camera. Just to remind you of that one, that's the camera one. No, it's not that one. No, I'd have to dig it out. Dig it out, I think. It really bugged me to change all of these. I have changed the settings and I thought it would default, but it never does default. So that's for very weird. Actually, what you can sometimes do is you can cheat and you can do this. Not the whole lot. And a spanner font. Vector and then chain through. Yep. And then if I just double check the next match all of these. What do you think, smashing? And then I can go and test them. But these should now be vector. No, not changed it. Why hasn't it changed it? Hey, don't understand. Spanner. Setting, vector, change group. Is it not far? Ah, I know. Because I haven't matched them first. I have to do things in order. So change group. Now. Vector. Wanna. Oh, you forget the cantations. Let's move the six screen around a bit. 7. Right, folks, it's 2 hours I've been going now. Right, I'm going to call it a day, guys. I will probably be streaming again on Wednesday. I will be down on Discord and the forum, finishing these things over the weekend. But whatever, I need to order some kind of early next week. I'll see how far I've got. But thank you all for spending time on the stream and participating. Have a nice weekend, folks, and I will see you either down on the forum, Discord, or on the stream next week. Ciao.